Always a fun time. Always fun. Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Hello.
What's on your face, drool? Angelo drooled on my face today.
Did he?
Yep.
How did that happen?
He was like laying on top of me and just drool came out of his mouth and it landed like on my chin.
Really?
Oh, I threw him off. I was like, get out of here.
And with that, we start the show. Hey, good evening, everybody. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How are you? Excited to be here. Let me just see. Let me see my Google Hangouts. I want to get closer.
So the chairs only go so close.
Okay, well, then you have to lean over. What do you like this? There we go. Hey, guys. Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How are you? Thank you for joining us on a Friday night for What Would Jeff Do? I missed this Wednesday night because I was actually there'll be no brain picking going on tonight. No. We don't do any of that stuff here. I missed Wednesday's show. I was actually up in hey, Mike, how are you?
Hey.
I was up in actually in where was
you
I? Delray.
Down. You were down.
I was down in Delray, Florida, having a great time. Oh, fantastic time. We have to go there.
Okay.
Next trip.
Let's go now.
No, we have a show today. All right. So this is what we do on historically on Mondays and Wednesdays. We'll call it Friday night just for purposes only. At 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Oh, we love you too. Just 3CS. And what you're going to be able to do is ask us dog training questions. Ask me dog training questions. Linda reads them. I do it. I'm the dog trainer. She's Linda's got her own little enterprise going on. And she asks the questions. Hey, Bethany, how are you? So let's get right into it. Hey, hello.
Mine is not saying that you're on.
No? Well, maybe you don't got me on there. I don't know what to tell you. I'm on right here. And happy Friday to you. Also, let's remember what you can do is you can heart me up. That's from tapping the screen. Little character in the corner. Click on that little character in the corner. And then you can share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter, share this on Periscope. But also, you want to check out all of my social media. I'm on Instagram, Snapchat, YouTube, everywhere. And a lot of good stuff. We're actually building an Amazon store of all the things. This is what I'm doing is I'm building an Amazon store that's going to be linked to my websites. And the reason is, and everybody always asks me like, hey, where do you get this? Where do you get that? Like this little stand that you have and, you know, what kind of lighting do you like for your periscopes and what kind of dog beds do you like? And you actually can go right on Amazon and buy it. So that'll be one of my newer projects that we're building. I started doing that today. Something was on my checklist today.
Check it off.
Yep, a lot of good stuff. A lot of fun stuff. So let's go. Let's get right into the questions. The show is for you. It's going to be ending at 10:05. At 10 o'clock, Linda leaves. At 10:05, I'm off the air because Linda's going to do her Periscope. My dog literally started screaming at other dogs when she passes them. How do I stop this? Well, Amanda, May, what I would do is this. First of all, what kind of leash collar setup? You know, what's the equipment that you're walking your dog on? So I'm a balanced trainer. So for the walk, I find the walk at the very beginning is most easily done with a prong collar. I would also do focus work as well. So you have to correct it. You have a head halter. Unfortunately, a head halter is not gonna fix the problem. A head halter will not fix the problem. If anything, it'll probably end up causing damage on the dog's neck, spine, with the head halter. I would actually switch to a prong collar. And I've got videos on my YouTube channel on how to pick them out, how to size them, how to put it on the dog, how to introduce it to the dog, and how to start walking. You need to correct the screaming. That bottom line, you need to correct the screaming. Barking, screaming, you have to correct, or the dog will keep doing it. Why is the dog doing it? Because they do. So tell the dog to shut up, pretty much. All right? My bull terrier likes to sit facing away from me when he goes into a sit command. Don't take it personally. Don't take it personally. I would absolutely not take it personally. What you can do is you can work on focus work if you want to. Focus work. What we do is we do remote collar focus. I've made some videos on that. It's all food-based. You can use the dog's daily food. We don't use treats. Just use the dog's daily food. And you can do that. Why is the dog, you know, looking away from you? There's probably asked five different trainers to all say five different things. So what I would do is I would just work on focus. German Shepherd is not listening to and the prong collar is off.
Remote
is off. How long have you been working on prong collar training? And are you putting it on and leaving it on for long periods of time? Right? I missed a question right there. How do you guys deal with dogs and cat issues? Do you have cats at the facility to train the dogs? We don't, but I've got a dog at home. And no, we do have a dog upstairs, a cat. We've got a cat at home. A few weeks, try a few months, a minimum of a few months. Your dog is not trained. A few weeks is nothing. A few weeks is nothing. You might have to go 6 solid months with just hardcore remote collar training. Imagine somebody going through sobriety. A few weeks is nothing. So if you've been sober for a couple of weeks, what's going to happen? You go into a bar, you're probably going to drink, right? You're doing rehab, right? We don't have a cat at the facility, but what we can do is we have other things that we can enact the dog's prey drive and stop them from it, right? What do I do when she starts the behavior? Well, you're not using the right tool. So what you're going to do is there's like 20 things you can do. At the beginning, you would correct for the energy. If the dog starts to whine around the energy, you can start utilizing a little bit of space to help you out with, but you're going to correct it. So I've got videos and I've done periscopes on how to correct all that whining. So what you're going to do is you're going to actually just say, you know, knock it off, and you give a correction. You cannot correct properly with a head halter. Head halters were not designed to really correct the dog. So you want to correct it. You pretty much want to just get the message across to the dog that you don't want the dog doing that anymore. Okay. So corrections are good. They're not bad. All right.
Extended down versus place.
They both have, they both have great value to them. The down is really, really good because you can down your dog anywhere. You don't need an object. Where place has to be an object. It could be a blanket. It could be a towel. It could be a dog bed. Both, your dog should know both, in my opinion. But place is good because it has a defined area. The dogs really, really like it. Dog is fine once he's in the prong collar, but will do anything to avoid me putting it on before the walks. So Bill, what I would do is this. I would do a prong collar food protocol. It's going to be with food, clicker, prong. Food, clicker, prong. What I would do is I would look up a video called Rupert collar conditioning video on my YouTube channel. This dog would attack, literally maul you if you try to put any collar on. Flat buckle collar, martingale collar, it doesn't make a difference. Also, if you try to touch its paws, it would attack you. So we did click, back then we didn't do clicker, but we just used a marker. We did yes, which all a clicker is a marker. We just did marker training and food. The only way that dog would eat is by having the collar on, collar off, collar on, collar off. We got that dog to run to us to put the collar on. And you can do that too. 2 weeks. Only way the dog eats, putting the collar on. All right? 14-week-old Maltese, saw your video with Maltese. What kind of collar do we use sitting with leash walk? 14-week Maltese, you can use a micro prong collar. You can use a slip lead, right? Use a slip lead. You scared of the clicker as well? Yeah, a lot of dogs get freaked out by the clicker. Just use the word yes. Do food with yes, food with yes, food with yes. So Maltese, you can train on a lot of different things. You can train on food, you can do clicker, you can do a micro prong collar, but 14-week-old Maltese, I would most likely just use a little bit of a slip lead. A little bit of a slip lead. All right. Okay. All right. Can you train a dog that is a chain dog? Is there any pros or cons? You want to get him off the chain, right? Get him off the chain first. But if he's chained, yeah, that would be really, really difficult to do. He won't chase any cats, though. That's the cool thing. But a dog that's been chained all of its life or most of its life or even for a year straight, no problem at all. Nope, no problem at all. And don't worry about the past. Dogs are really resilient. Dogs are really hardy animals. Take them off the chain and boom, that's it. How do you stop barking? If you're not in the house or around, you would use a bark collar, which automatically goes off when the dog barks. So you do a little bit of a stim or a lot of stim. The dog will always let you know what the levels are. If you're in the house, you can use a remote collar. You can use a bonker, which is just a wrapped up towel. You would say no, you throw the towel at the dog. Any aversion, you want to correct or use an aversion, and it's a punisher to stop barking. You actually can punish behavior. So being a balanced trainer, it's like we do yes and we do no. So you absolutely would punish the dog for barking when you don't want it to be. You have to. You don't just reward the dog for being quiet. That'll never stop the dog from barking. It won't.
Okay, someone has a dog that they want to teach how to bark only when they want it to.
I don't use spray bottles with water. I don't recommend spray bottles with water at all. The dog will be afraid of spray bottles, and there's a lot of things you'd want to actually use a spray bottle for. Like a flea and tick comes in a spray bottle. They come with a waterless bath. We don't use spray bottles, and who wants to carry around a spray bottle? So what was the question?
Someone wants to teach their dog to bark only when they want them to.
I don't teach the bark command, but you can teach the bark command. What you want to do is you will want to get a look up for a YouTube video, and that's a sport dog trainer. You can actually turn it into a trick if you want to, but you can also just – sport dog trainers teach bark. I don't teach bark. I teach shut up. Okay? What else?
German Shepherds started spinning in the last 2 months. What's the protocol for
that? You have to interrupt it. You've got to interrupt the spinning. Interrupt the spinning. So what I would do is I would do down in place right off the bat, down in place right off the bat. So that's what I would do. Be proactive instead of reactive. Proactive instead of reactive. So that's how you would stop the spinning, but you can also interrupt the spinning. Can also interrupt the spinning. The dog is obviously, its mind is racing. So we always talk about tons of exercise, but even you could do 20 miles a day, the dog could still spin because the dog needs to be rested mentally. That's where place and down comes in. Place and down comes in. How to shut up the neighbor's dog? Call animal control. Call animal control. That's all you can do.
Is it okay to use a bark collar when you're not around?
That's what bark collars are for. That's what bark collars are for. So is it safe to leave the bark collar on unattended? Only if you've tried it when you've been around. In other words, you need to know what the collar is going to do when the dog barks. I don't recommend the adjustable ones, which increase in intensity as the dog barks, because that could be a vicious cycle. So most bark collars go from like 1 to 8. And what I would do is just put it on 1, make sure it's on snug. Dog barks, does nothing. Keeps barking. 2, dog barks. Nothing happens, keeps barking. Bark 3, number 3, the dog goes, ow! And then stops barking. Bingo, number 3 it is. There you go. So always test the equipment while you're there. Always test the equipment while you're there, right? My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Solid Canine Training. Little character in the corner. Click on that little character in the corner. Share this on Facebook. Share this on Twitter. Share this on Periscope. Also, don't forget on the replays, you can also share my Periscopes. How do you do that? On an iOS, you'd swipe right to, left to right. On an Android, you do up and down, and you can still give hearts on the replays. I love all my people that watch my replays. Thank you so much. I feel really honored that you're actually watching this. You know what you want watching this. Oh, hey, John, how you doing? We're going to have a great time in New Orleans. It's going to be a lot of fun. Mardi Gras going on, too. Mardi Gras going on. All right, my two-year-old Malinois is great with my wife until I get home, and then he freaks. How can I stop that? Aha! So you're the trigger. You're the trigger. So what I would make sure is, what's your energy like? Well, first of all, Malinois, they've got a lot of energy, right? Now, so you might be the spark that makes the explosion happen. So what I would do is I would check your energy. Check your energy. Are you just the fun guy? Are you the fun guy? Do you just come home from work and you're like, yeah, let's party, let's play frisbee and catch and let's wrestle? Or are you the one that's going, hey, cut the shit? You know, sit, down, place, recall, you know? Heal. So what's your, the main guy in charge? Well, it sounds like you're the main fun guy. It sounds like your wife's just relaxed with your wife, but he's too elevated with you. So what I would do is I would just check your energy. Just check your energy and see what's going on with that, and make sure your wife is also doing commands as well. So he's probably getting excited to work. Dogs love to work. Malinois really love to work. Really love to work. So that's what I would do with that. All right, awesome.
Can't get my dog to lay down with the prong collar footprint.
So what I would do is use food. Use a food lure. Use a food lure. So get the dog down with a food lure and pressure. Down with a food lure and then pressure. So try that. Also, there's a thing you can do with you actually take sit on the ground, put your leg out so it's like a little bit crooked like that. Take a food lure, put it underneath your leg. The dog's got to crawl underneath your leg. Boom, dog down. Try that. When you're first teaching down, I don't care what you got to do. You just get that dog down. Once that dog understands what down is, you'll be all set. You'll be all set.
I like to bring my dog to my store. She barks and reacts. I just want her to stop when told.
Then teach her how to shut up. So to me, I don't want your dog barking at the store at all. I don't want your dog barking at the store. That's annoying, right? It's a great way for customers to leave. It's got to be annoying for you. It's also stressful for the dog. Dogs barking are annoying. So what I want you to do is I want you to tell the dog to shut up. How do you do that? Remote collar. Remote collar. Shut up. Remote collars are great. They're for yes and for no. That's going to be one of the no ones, though. It's going to be a no one. All right, what else? Nothing else? Come on. Guys, let's go. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. I'll just do some promotion here. Go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. I tour the world doing seminars. Oh, awesome, Crumples. That's great.
Sorry to go back to bark collar. When is a good time to not put collar on when not home?
There's no good time. That's what bark collars are designed for. Bark collars have been designed for when you're not home because they correct the dog when nobody's there. That's the perfect time for a bark collar. That's why they're, you're right. Any advice as a first-time St. Bernard owner? I would be prepared for a lot of slobber. And then also what I would do is do nothing different. Check to make sure its hips are okay, its knees are okay. Keep the dog physically fit. Don't let the dog get overweight. But from a training standpoint, I train St. Bernard's the way I train every other thing. Bark collar, does it stand forever? Well, if you're gone forever, but you're probably not gone forever. So what I would do is this, is it's okay when you leave to work, you put the equipment on the dog. It's equipment, right? So if you're gone for 8 hours a day, then you would leave the bark collar on. Current trainer doesn't want to use an e-collar. Well, then that's your trainer, right? That's your trainer. I don't understand why a trainer, well, I do. I shouldn't say that. E-collars are not mean or bad or abusive or harmful to dogs. They're just not. People have got to stop thinking that. So I can harm a dog way more with my hands than a remote collar can. You know, I can. I can hurt a dog with a spoon. I can take a wooden spoon and harm a dog. I can scare the shit out of a dog more with a wooden spoon than a remote collar. So it might be the wrong trainer for you. And if you're already working with a trainer, you should get the trainer to answer the questions that you have. So if the trainer can't help you, it's time to find a new trainer. Do I mean? Does that make sense? So in other words, if your trainer can't help you with a problem, well then it's time to move on. All right? So I'm a big advocate of using as many different tools as you can. So if your trainer has a way to stop something else, then that's great. But if they don't know how, they're not being much help. Why do trainers want to wait till dog is 6 months old? For obedience, 6 months sometimes is a really good age. For behavior modification, you can correct a dog way before 6 months. But from a learning curve of obedience, you really don't you can correct a dog. I mean, I would be careful about high corrections for obedience, but if you start training that dog at, say, 3 months old on obedience, that gives you 3 months of hardcore training. You might want to do some light corrections, but it all depends. I mean, giving a heavy correction for, I've done it. I've corrected 5-month-old dogs for not doing an obedience command that it knew. Dogs trained up fine. You just want to be careful about not being correction heavy pre-6 months on obedience commands. But some people think you shouldn't train a dog until it's 6 months old. So everybody's got a different opinion. Everyone's got a different opinion. Why do trainers want to wait? Okay, I suggest dogs in crates no more than 6 hours in crate without a break during the day. What do you suggest? Well, the problem with that is, how about if the owner is gone for 8 hours? So sometimes, ideally, would be great. 6 hours would be great. But if the owner is gone for 8 hours, what are you gonna do? Dog walker, yes. Doggy daycare, yes. Come home with lunch, yes. But how about if they can't do any of that stuff? I firmly believe they still have the right to have the dog. So sometimes we have to say to ourselves, well, if it's not practical or reasonable for the owners, what are we gonna do about it? I don't want them to get rid of a dog because they have to leave the dog in the crate for 8 hours. That's a hard one. But 6 hours, I have no problem with. 8 hours, pushing it. But most people work an 8-hour shift. All right. Okay. We can't get your German Shepherd to leave the dog alone. So what I would do is the cat alone.
It's too rough. The cat doesn't want to play.
To tell the dog to shut, knock it off. Remote collar, aversion training. Bam, that sucked. So that's what I would do. I would put that dog into avoidance. Put the dog into avoidance. You go after my cat, I'm going to make your life really, really suck. High level correction for that. Ah! Sounds mean, doesn't it? But what's even meaner is this: dead cat. Or the cat scratches the dog's eyeballs out if it has its claws. So if it doesn't have his claws, someone's gotta claw the dog. That's gotta be you. That's why I like remote collars. It's a cat claw. Oh, he's got claws? Well, one of these days, Crumples, cool name by the way, Crumples 10. One of these days, that cat's gonna just let him have it, right? Read that question.
What do you do if you're trading place and you can lure the dog on, but the dog won't leave place?
You shouldn't be luring, you should be training. So for training, what I want you to do is have a leash on the dog. So you have a leash on the dog and break, take the leash, pull the dog off. So all your obedience training at the beginning should be done with a leash. Leash should be on the dog. So you say, if you say the release command, pick up the leash, there you go. Let me explain what that command means to you. So getting the dog on, getting the dog off or thing, but don't lure. Just lead. How about that? That's a better word. Let's lead the dog onto it. And then eventually we just command the dog onto it. All right?
How do I stop my dog from leaning on me?
What I would do is I would take the leg that he's leaning on, just push him away. Push him away from you with your leg, or you can put him in place and put him in down. And make sure he doesn't follow you around. That's annoying. So, guys, remember, they're dogs. Don't be afraid to do something. So don't be afraid to take a chance with dog training. They're dogs. You're not going to F them up. You won't. You won't. I mean, and keep in mind also that they're dogs and we're humans and we all struggle with lots of different things and we always expect our dogs to be perfect. That doesn't mean we should not train our dogs. What I'm saying is I make mistakes every day. It's okay to try something with your dog and see if it works. If it doesn't work, then try something else. But don't be afraid to take a chance. Don't be afraid to take a chance. I'm giving you permission to F up, okay? I'm giving you permission. No, you're not supposed to know everything about dogs. Most dog trainers, like I probably know 1% about dog training, and I consider myself a pretty good dog trainer, but I probably know about 1%. There's so much to learn, right? So make a mistake, take a chance, all right? 14-week-old puppy, should I be taking them out every 3 hours working on potty training? Yep, that sounds about right. Put a leash on the dog, go to the same door, make the dog wait at the door, go out to the same spot in the yard, tell the dog to go potty. Go potty, good. Even clicking food if you want to, but same spot every time. And then come back in, put the dog back in the crate, and then if you want to do a training module, then take the dog out after that. So if you're trying to crate train, house break the dog, you, from the crate, to the door, to waiting at the threshold, to the potty spot, potty command, reward if you want to. Don't go schoolgirl crazy. Oh my God, you did good. Freaking dog dumped. Okay? I take a dump, people run. Nobody gives me shit for taking a dump. All right? Nobody gives me shit for taking a shit, right? So then what I want you to do is bring the dog back in, kennel the dog back up, and then bring the dog out to do some training or do some play or do something else. I want that dog to know there's a defined potty time. Want to read the question?
Is it good to take breaks throughout the week from dog training?
Absolutely. Hell yeah. Of course it is. Yeah, just let the dog decompress. Soak time. Just do some soak time. But theoretically, everything's training. Theoretically, everything's training. I hope she doesn't have to go outside. So theoretically, everything is dog training. So right now, I've got dogs in place and a dog in down. And my kids are in the library. Oh, Smeejay, thank you. Is this your first time on live? Yeah, is this your first time live? Yeah, we normally don't do them on Friday nights. We do Monday and Wednesday nights. All right? Thank you. So yeah, you take a break. But technically, dog training, oh, awesome. Thank you. So technically, dog training is life. It's just life. That's what it is. There's something called good manners. Oram, it has been a while. So there's good manners, right? You got good manners. Okay, and you got training. Are you going to do a scope tonight?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, she's going to do a periscope too.
Oh, no. I'm really exhausted.
Just do a short one. Do a 20-minute scope. Jillian, you love me, man? Oh, I love you too. I hope to become a dog trainer too, but I don't know how to. Either did I. I didn't know how to become a dog trainer either until I started training dogs. So just do that. Start training dogs. Grab a dog, train it. Grab another dog, train it. Grab another dog, train it. Make mistakes. Make mistakes. So what I would do is this. I've got a seminar series called Train the Trainers. Train the Trainers with Sean and Jeff.com. You can go to that. I've got a seminar in Ellington, Florida, starting on Monday. It's a 7-day seminar. We've got a 2-day seminar in New Orleans coming up. Yep. Yep. It's going to be great. HT1122. That's your code. You realize that I'm going to call you that the whole seminar. I'm going to call you by your handle, HT1122. I will not use your real name. I'm going to refuse to. I'm going to say, excuse me, HT1122. Did you have a question? HT1122, your dog is barking. HT1122, could you please give me lunch? Yep. That's it. I think we should call everybody by their Periscope names.
They're not on Periscope.
Then they better be on Periscope if they want to be a successful dog trainer. Am I hiring in California? Yes, I am. You start tomorrow. I'll pay you $25 an hour. Show up tomorrow. 123 Main Street, San Diego, California, 92122. All right? Okay, it's a Middle Eastern restaurant, but we're doing dog training out of the back. Trust me. I'll see you tomorrow. All right, what else? Ask questions, guys. Ask questions and you'll get answers.
Are you trying to be Gary Vee?
Is that what he says?
No, but he's almost.
Oh. I think but I'm older than him, so he's trying to be me. So Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, Solid Canine Training. Right there. Solid Canine Training right there. This is Linda.
Guys.
In New Hampshire? Oh no, we don't. We're in Providence, Rhode Island. Potential. That's a cute name. Real Potential. I am local to you. I'm based in Providence, Rhode Island. Right? All right. Food Runners for Ellington.
It's Ellington.
Ellington. That's a. She doesn't have wine. She's got actually no. She's got chocolate wine.
I've got the chocolate vino from Mama Homes.
Yes.
Choco vino.
Yep. Yep, San Bernardino. Yep, we're hiring there. 123 Main Street in San Bernardino. All right?
Will you stop?
So what I want you to do is...
No, HT122, you did miss a lot. Don't listen to canine board and training.
For puppies in the house, outside of crate, leash... Oh, yeah, absolutely. For any dog that's not trained, leash on. Always, always. HT1122, I professed my love to you. That's what I did. I professed my love to you. I asked for your hand in marriage. That's what I did. You missed it. You missed it, so it can't be real. It can't be real. No, I don't. I'm in Providence, Rhode Island. I'm not in Los Angeles. I'm not in San Bernardino. I'm not in California, so I can't hire you.
How do I know a shelter dog is stable?
Ooh, that's a good one. Oh, looking to adopt, any tips for finding the right dog? We'll put those in. This is what I want you to do. Go to the shelter or go to a rescue. Go to a rescue. That's what I would do. I would go to a rescue and test. 1, 2, 3, Stephen. 1, 2, 3. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Stephen, can you hear me?
What are we testing?
1, 2, 3. I don't know. You put test. Test. 2 times 2 is 4. Square root of 9 is, I don't know, 3. That's 3. All right, what I want you to do is this, no aggression. Okay, let's wipe aggression off the map. No human, no dog aggression. What I would do is I want to find one that's not going nuts, and I don't want to find one that's hiding in the corner. What I would do is I would find one from a foster home, foster or rescue, that's living with somebody that knows the dog a little bit better. Or a smaller shelter that has more intimate experience with the dogs, not just some big, huge shelter. It's hard to tell. It's hard to tell. It's really, really hard to tell. So that's what I would do. Shelter life is not conducive to good behavior. It's just not. It's just not. The correct setting on the mini educator, it's the right setting. There is no correct setting. Don't worry about the number. Pay attention to the dog. To get the working level, I've got a video on my YouTube channel on how to get the working level, which is the minimum level the dog can feel it. But I don't want you to be married to a number, all right? I mean, I'm married to number 6. She's my 6th wife. So, but I don't call her number 6. I call her hun, all right? So, and that's her smiling. See that? Look at that smiling face. Look at that.
When I'm looking around, what am I doing?
You're looking, probably looking for something to throw at me? Shit. So don't worry about the number. Don't worry about the number. Everybody worries about the number. Looking for a corrective level? 20, 30. When the dog stops what you're doing, what it's doing that you don't want it to do. That's the corrective level. Okay, that's the corrective level. Are you correcting for obedience or behavior modification, though? Obedience or behavior modification? All depends. Right, what's next?
Tips on
a dog. Oh, to keep from what? Wait, hold on. To keep from whining the dishwasher? Getting in the, oh, that would be the highest level.
We don't do tricks.
No, I don't do tricks. Go to Red Mark Training. Red Mark Training. She does a Periscope. Her name is Morgan. It's all clicker training. Clicker training and food with tricks.
She's good.
She's really good. Yep. Her name is Morgan. They're based in Texas. Red Mark Training. Go to them. Look them up on Periscope. She does like a Tuesday trick scope. Yep, you'll learn a lot. You'll learn a lot. Yep, I don't do tricks. You know why? Tricks don't save dogs' lives, and that's all I'm interested in, is saving dogs' lives. That's all I want to do. So for behavior, so yeah. Oh, that's the highest level. So Steven Jantz, you go by, you go in the dishwasher, you go in the garbage, I'm gonna hit you on 90. Bam. That's it. Oh, it sucks. Yep, it sucks. You eat a sock, poof, woo! Yep. Yep, it shouldn't be fun. You shouldn't enjoy it at all. It should not be, it's not nice to, it's not fun to do, but the dog needs to understand, listen, if you eat that poop, same thing. Oh. Yep, same thing. You have to. You want to instill the fear of God in that dog, that if it ever eats another, you know what? It costs $3,500 to $5,000 to remove a sock from a dog. Unless you live in Texas, it's $1,200. But still, it's expensive, and the dog could die on the table. And they never learn. But for 3 seconds out of the dog's life, guess what? Oh, it learns. For dogs that struggle in the wire crate, I would do, what's that one-piece crate? Custom crates? No. Custom crates with a K? Just get a winger zinger. Get a winger zinger crate. Invest in a winger zinger crate. I would do that. I would at least a winger zinger crate. That's what I would do. That's what I would do. Yep. And you got to, or zip tie all your weak points on your wire crate, use carabiners on the front. How do you train a dog to drop it? We do the out command. That's all with a remote collar. So we say out. Oops. Girl's going to break command.
You never talked about adopting the right dog.
Sure I did.
No, you didn't.
So adopting the right dog, I said no aggression, human or dog. Don't find one that's super shy. Don't want to find one that's super exuberant unless you're trying to dog.
You said all that stuff.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, you were looking around for something to throw at me. Do I think that many people use the brown collar wrong? I know it's safer. This is the thing. I think it's really hard to, yes, I think it's wrong. Thank you, Smeegee. Yes, I think a lot of people use it wrong, but a lot of people do not hurt their dogs on prong collars. It is extremely, extremely difficult to hurt their dogs on a prong collar. More dogs are hurt on flat buckle collars than any other collar out there. More dogs are hurt on slip leads than any other collar out there. Hurting a dog on a prong collar is extremely, extremely difficult to do, even if you use it wrong. Yes, you can use a prong collar to drop it. Yep, you would just use a, you can do a couple of different things. Hold the dog up or give a pop. Or you can use a puppy test. So Terry uses a, she has a test that she uses on adult dogs. That's how you can test them. Yep. Volhard. Volhard has a test. So go to volhardnutrition.com, volhardnutrition.com, and they've got a test. I imagine that's where it is. Right, Terry? Is that where it would be? She's got a seminar coming up, I think, over at Scott McConaughey's place, too, in Ohio. I think he's doing a seminar. Yep. Yes. Yep. Awesome. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. I've got a training center in Providence, Rhode Island. I've got a great staff of 9 who is rocking it and killing it, and they're doing a great job there. We specialize in aggression rehab, heavy behavior modification. We deal with young puppies. I got an itch in my nose, but I travel the world doing seminars. I'm right down here in Florida right now. I'm doing 2 seminars in Florida, 1 in New Orleans. You have a Chihuahua who won't do a down. Oh, you just use food. Just use food. Do food, a food lure. Do a food lure. It'll do it. Do a food lure. Maybe take two little fingers behind the head, a little bit of guidance like that. No, we don't train for the CGC. Nope. Don't train for the CGC. I've never given the CGC test. I've never trained anybody for the CGC at all. I don't even know the rules for CGC, but I'm not against the CGC, but I think it gives a lot of people a false sense of security. My dog passed at CGC, but it bites my kids. But do it. Go ahead. Go ahead. Yep. Yeah. Yep. I'm not anti-CGC, just to clarify. All right? I'm not anti any letters in the alphabet, just to clarify. A through Z, I love them all. What's next? It's got to be something. Come on, guys. HT 1122, you're going to kill it. You're going to kill it. I need questions. If not, I'm just going to keep talking and talking and talking. Today, I did social media today. I edited three videos today. I became an Amazon associate today. I did some social media today. What else did I do?
We went on a
beautiful walk today. Oh, did you see the video earlier? I put up a video of a girl doing a little bit of tug where Angelo helped me do some bite work. We did that, played Chuck It, took the Chihuahuas for a nice walk. We ran out and got a pint of ice cream tonight. We went to the Publix down the street. What did we get?
The one with the cake in it, right?
Yeah. Service dog training. The only thing I do for service dog training is public access. So I'll do obedience and public access. I don't know how to do any tasks. So I don't know how to do tasks like light switches or pick things up. Those would fit into the trick category. So what I would do is that would all be clicker training for tasks.
Half baked.
We got half baked. Are you ready for a foster? Yes, you are. You're ready for a fall. HT 1122, you're ready for a lot of stuff. Amazon associate, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a shopping cart. Amazon, I'm going to put a
shopping cart. Is it an affiliate?
An affiliate. Duh. Amazon affiliates. What I'm going to do is this. I recommend so many products to so many people. All these people say, hey, like, Jeff, where did you get this water bottle? Hey, Jeff, what kind of iPhone case do you have? Hey, Jeff, what kind of lighting do you have? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all these products that I use every single day in my life for my business, for my personal, all the books that I read, I'm going to put them in a shopping cart. And then what happens is you get 4%. Yep. And most of that's going to go towards my nonprofit. No, crate the door. Close the crate door. That's how the puppy stays in. Close the crate door. Yeah. Your dog, get that dog's butt in there. Kennel up, close the door. Yeah, why would you leave the crate door open? Because you feel bad, right? You feel bad, don't you? Admit it. Say, I feel bad. Say it. I feel bad. Write it out. I'll stop this damn show unless you write that. I feel bad. The Amazon Prime is good. Good. You're supposed to leave it closed. That's what the door is there for. Unless you live in, if you lived in Sweden, you can't close the door. They'll fine you. Guys, you guys are getting the meatball. You guys did such a good job on the meatballs, you can't get the freaking crate done. How to stop dogs from fighting over toys and food? That's a major, major, major structure leadership problems. I gotcha. Told you you did. I know it. I know you so well. I know you better than you know yourself, right? So stop with the feeling bad. You feel bad? How about this? Ready? You ready for this? Your dog gets out of the crate in the middle of the night and shits and pisses all over the floor. Who's feeling bad now, right? Who's feeling bad now? So.
Not the dog.
Dog's loving it. Dog's going, I shit on the carpet. You ever seen a dog do a shit on the carpet dance? It looks like the Macarena. I'm telling you.
I thought it was like the electric slide. Yeah.
So, all right, hold on. We missed some other stuff. Oh, how to stop your dog. So if you've got dogs that are fighting over toys and food, you've got a major leadership problem in your house. What I would be doing is this. Ready? Take away all your affection. Massive amounts of structure. Each one of those dogs should be crated at night and when you're not home. Got it? I want those dogs to be in place. I want those dogs to be in a down. I want those dogs to have no free roaming. I want them to earn every piece of kibble that they ever got. I want those dogs to never be on any furniture. I want those dogs to not be in any beds. I want those dogs to be having leashes on at all times. I want those dogs to be getting zero affection. Got it? The only time they are going to be having fun is when they do play. The play will be deemed structured by you. You start it, you stop it. Those dogs should be remote collar trained. You get aggressive, I make your life suck. That's a start. Do you suggest T3 program or shadowing programs for someone who has their own business? I would do T3. I would do one of the T3s first. T3 first and then shadow, because then the shadow makes sense. Then make I don't know anything about mange whatsoever. I've had mange on my balls for 2 years. I can't get rid of it. So if I did, I'd know.
I don't even want to open my eyes right now.
I'm sorry. It just felt so right to say that. It just felt right.
It just felt so wrong to hear
it. It did. It just felt right.
I'm not opening my eyes ever again. That's it. I'm keeping my eyes
I'm sorry. It felt right. Come on. Did I do it right? It did, right? So listen,
can't even.
No, T3 is not going to be in Maryland. There's a T3, there's going to be a T3 in Providence, Rhode Island. Baltimore is close to Providence, Rhode Island. You guys are local. Just keep in mind that nobody that goes to a T3 lives around here, right? Everybody flies in or drives in.
Stop laughing. Don't encourage him.
It just felt
You're
right.
You're encouraging the
No. No, it felt right. Come on. It did. Is he allowed to break the place? Technically, no. Technically, no. So I would just tell him no and put him back. Yeah, canine boarding train is coming from California all the way to Florida. 3,000 miles. All right? HT is local. You're still driving an hour, though.
Who is HT?
I'm not telling you. It's Heather, HT, Heather, all right? So what did we miss? Yeah, they do have a shampoo, all right? Lexington or Dallas training, wondering if one is better choice than the other. Well, those are RV dog training seminars. That's a good one. I like Lexington. I don't want to say better. Why don't you go to both? Go to both. We have people that do both of them. So. Closest T3 to Montreal, Quebec, Providence, Rhode Island. Providence, Rhode Island. But they're RVs, they're cheap. They're $200 and $350. If you go to both Lexington and Dallas, I'll give you a price break. Because that's RV. RV is just me. I can do stuff like that. T3, no negotiating. No negotiating. That's a more intense program. But RV, if you want to go to both RVs, one in Lexington, one in Dallas, please, I'll help you out. I'll help you out. Now, Lexington is nice. Barbecue. So when are you going to drop a T3? We're not going to do a T3 at Blake's. Nope, that's New York. You might as well go to Providence for that. You might as well go to Providence. Blake's doing his own stuff, too. Blake's got his own seminars. He's got his own seminars doing. I think he's doing a couple different seminars. You'll consider it. All right, let me know. If your dog doesn't respond to a high level on his remote couch, should I go to level 100? All depends on what the dog is doing and what you consider a high level. So you don't do, like, if the dog doesn't sit, you don't go, like, to 100. That's not fair. That's not fair. So I need more information. I'm not going to answer that question until I got more information, Jillian. What else? What did you do today? Homeschool the kids?
Mm-hmm.
What did the kids do in school?
They did some reading.
Nice.
They did some math.
Nice.
Some science.
No, wow, really?
Mm-hmm. Ooh, we didn't read our history. We're reading about the American Revolution.
Really?
Yeah.
That's an interesting era.
Yeah. Spelling.
Nice.
Clover does vocabulary now.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Why is Angelo swearing all the time? He's dropping, he's swearing a lot.
He said, cut the shit.
I know, he goes, cut the shit. Angelo said, cut the shit. When he chews and locks onto an item in the house, won't let go, oh, that will be at 100. That's how you do your out. Out, boom. You read an interesting, yes, dogs are over-vaccinated, humans are over-vaccinated. Oh, someone else may ask me about spay and neuters. Spay and neuter, I'm a big advocate for, but it doesn't eliminate aggression. If you're not gonna breed your dog, spay and neuter him. Yep, spay and neuter him. So, but yes, dogs over vaccinated. It's all based on the drug companies. So technically, once your dog gets the rabies shot, the dog don't need the rabies shot anymore. In Rhode Island, here's an interesting concept. Ready? The state of Rhode Island, we just switched from 1 year rabies to 3 year rabies. All right. So, but listen to this concept. Ready? That I don't know about spay and neuter what age. That's a vet question, and you'll get about 20 different answers if you ask 20 different vets. So I don't know. I'm not the guy to ask on that one. We just went to a 3 year rabies. All right. If I miss the 3 year rabies by one day, so say, what's today? Today's the 22nd. So if my dog's rabies vaccination expires today on the 22nd, all right, and then we go to the, and then I bring my dog into the vet on the 23rd. One day, I cannot get a 3 year rabies. They will give me a 1 year rabies. But guess what? It's the same freaking vaccination. It's literally the exact same dose, the exact same syringe. It's the same stuff inside because I missed it by one day. It's ridiculous. And it might not even be 24 hours. It could be 12 hours. Oh, thank you. I thought it was my charming good looks and my massive love for St. Bernards.
Is there a difference between the shot?
Go ahead.
I can't disappear.
Yeah, I would not go. I would absolutely not go with inexpensive remote collars. I would absolutely not go with, yeah. Nope. I would go with either eCower Technologies. I'm a big fan of eCower.com. eCower.com. So go to eCower.com. You can also go with Dogtra. You can also go with Sport Dog. Yep. Don't worry about being late.
It's okay, Angie.
Yeah. Want to do a selfie shot?
Sure.
Let's do a selfie shot, right? Okay. Ready? So, does everybody know how to do a selfie shot? You guys don't know how to do a selfie? You're going to tweet this to me. You're going to tweet me a photo. All right? So this is what you're going to do. You're going to take a screenshot of Linda and I, and then you're going to tweet it to us. Tweet it to me. So you take a screenshot, and then you go to your Twitter, you hit to make a tweet, you put @SolidK9Training, you put our picture in there, and then you put a little caption. All right? And you put, my balls have mange.
No, don't make anybody type that.
Yes, my balls have mange. You're gonna put that in there, and then I will send you a video. Ready?
Quick pibble pause.
Screenshot, ready? All right, there's your screenshot. Awesome. So you want to tweet it to me, and then I'll send you back a video. If you swim in that canal, you may lose all your hair. If I swim in that canal, I'll probably lose. I'll tell you what. I'll get rid of my mange. There's sharks in that canal. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I was going to swim girl in there, and I said, nope. So, all right, what else do we got? Come on, guys. Let's go. So this is what we're gonna do. So Linda's gonna do a Periscope tonight, and then we're gonna do tomorrow is, I'm gonna do a Periscope of me and the kids setting up for T3. Oh, thanks, begging for balance. Thanks.
We can't help it.
Jeff's balls have mange, got it. But it's gotta be, but you have to tweet it to me. Sport dog collars, I don't train on them. I have used them before if my client has them. I prefer to train on eCower Technologies. And then if the owner wants to use the sport dog because the dog is trained, that's fine. eCower.com, I think they ship to Ontario. I'll be in Canada, in Ottawa and in Toronto. That's for RV dog trainer. I'll be doing that. Coming up when it's not cold. That's why we're in Florida. Yes, I use Webinar Jam, but I don't take questions on it. I don't take questions on it because I like to look at my chat. I don't have too many cameras on me. Yep. How tight should the collar be? For a remote collar, it should be super, super snug so it makes good contact.
Just wondering, do you do a refresher with e-collar?
Yep. Sure. If your dog is slacking on commands, you can always give him a little tune up. But it's training like everything else. Struggling with fearful of strangers and new people. So if you've got a dog that the prong collar should be snug as well, up high and snug. You don't have it to be loose. So if your dog is struggling with fearful, what I want you to do is this right now. I want your dog to be around people, but not meeting people. Okay? Around people, but not meeting people. Does that make sense? I want your dog to learn how to exist, but not necessarily interact. Start out by doing that. Start out with that. All right? So advocate for your dog. Advocate for your dog. Do not do the auto, setting on the remote on the bark collar, because if it can go up too high before it shuts off, and then your dog is going to freak out. I like the bark collar. The bark collar should be snug, and then what I want the dog to do is you set it at the lowest setting, and then you let the dog barks and watch the dog. If it didn't shut up, go to the next setting. Dog barks. So you always want to be there when you're setting up your bark collar.
I didn't understand this question.
What is one does what? Frank the Big Saint, what is one does Periscope name? What is this? Why, come on.
Do you think the yellow bag of Pedigree dog food from Walmart is good?
No, I don't. Pedigree is not good. Go to dogfoodadvisor.com. Dogfoodadvisor.com. Confidence building exercises. I want you to work on agility equipment. I want you to go underneath things. I want you to go over things. I want you to teach your dog tricks. I want you to teach your dog duration work. I want you to teach that dog ball play. Have some fun with your dog. Teach your dog how to be off leash. Make sure it's got all its on leash commands. Yes, he's doing great. It's the people I tell them not to pep. They don't listen? Please. Pivotal pause. Are you a male or a female? Pivotal pause. Are you a male or female? And are you over 18? Thank you, begging for balance. You know where I'm going with this. What kind of dog do you recommend for pit bull? Pit bulls eat the same food as every other dog. I do Volhard Nutrition. Fromm is good. Canada is good. Go to dogfoodadvisor.com. Yeah, pit bulls don't need any other special diet. Female. Oh, you're Jen. Okay, so pit bull paws. I like boobs. All right? I like boobs. If I walked up to you and I said, oh, you've got nice boobs, and I went to grab your boobs, what would you do? What would you do, Jen? So whatever you would do, you have to have that same philosophy about your dog. Don't touch my freaking dog. Got it? So you have to have that same energy. So what I would do is I'd be, back off. Don't touch my dog. Put your dog behind you. Step in front of your dog. Push the person away. Talk in a really firm voice. All right? Really firm voice. When someone's hitting on you at a bar and you don't want them to come near you, you do the exact same voice. Back off. Back off. So that's what I would do. Because you're not advocating for your dog. You're not advocating for your dog. So mean it. Say it like you mean it. Say it like you mean it. So I don't think you'd allow somebody to just grab your boobs. Are e-collars okay? Oh, absolutely. E-collars are great for every dog. When we get a fearful, nervous dog in, we put an e-collar on them the first day. Yep. Good, Pibble Paws.
Hey, what do you do about excitement pee when I come home or have company?
I hate that. I know. Oh. I hate that. So this is what I would do. What I would do is this. Come home neutral. Make sure your dog is crated. Come home neutral. When you leave, no excitement. When you come home, ignore the dog. I'd rather, first of all, check, make sure it's not a medical, right? Make sure it's not medical. What I want you to do is, you have to just make the inside environment so neutral and so calm. So neutral and so calm. And then what I would do is put the leash on the dog, walk calmly to the door, and have the dog go outside. Have the dog go outside. You've got to sort of reprogram that dog's bladder. It's a pain in the ass. I would rather work with a biting dog than an excitement peer. I'm telling you, I would. I would. I feel for you. I feel for you. Suggestions for crate anxiety. Watch my video. Watch my video on separation anxiety. It's on YouTube. Look it up. Okay?
Hey, our Galvin before was asking about the levels on a bark collar.
Right.
She's confused. She's like, do I let the dog bark?
Yeah. Yeah, you have to make the dog bark. Knock on the door, ring the doorbell. Absolutely. Yeah. Most you won't know if it works or not. Coach, who's that? Coach David Bard, can you guys give me a skinny burger and mail it to me? Sure. Absolutely. We're right down the street for Skinny Burgers. Skinny Burgers is on the side street.
Uh-uh.
Yes, it is. Yeah, I drove by Skinny Burgers the other day.
I've never heard of it.
Yep. Yep. I drove by.
You're making that up.
No, wait. Talk.
How come we didn't go to Skinny Burgers? Do they keep you skinny? My friend gives his dog beer. Is that bad?
Yeah.
It's really
bad.
Yeah,
your friend is abusing dogs. Yeah, but it comes with surf shop. Yep.
Oh, okay.
Yep. It's right here. What's next? Go ahead. No dead air. I'm looking up for Skinny Burgers.
No, don't look up Skinny Burgers. Who gives a crap?
He does. Anyway, okay.
You can't find it.
All right.
5 minutes.
Okay, thanks. Just want to buy the public beer right across from the surf shop. My friend gives his dog. Yeah, that's a major dick move to give your dog beer. Also, blowing smoke in your dog's pot smoke in your dog's face is also a major dick move.
Not only is alcohol bad, but doesn't beer have yeast in it?
Yeah.
And that's really bad for dogs.
Yeah.
It can mess up their stomach.
Yeah. So we missed some questions. So crate anxiety. What I want you to do is I want you to teach that dog to kennel up and then down. So you say kennel up, down, kennel up, down, kennel up, down. That's what I want you to do. But I don't drink alcohol. So the first place about the girls looking for a kennel.
I'll drink your beer, Jeff.
Duffy's is great also, yeah. We got kids here, though. We got kids. Hold on. Girl pots. Girl's looking for a kennel. Girl pots. Good girl. Yeah, girl's running around looking for a kennel to go into. Starting a company name changeover, any tips? Just do it. Just do it.
Oh, kid friendly.
Duffy's, yeah. Tracy, I want to go to that rib place right by your house. That rib place. Oh, by the way, Tracy, I forget. Tracy, I thought tomorrow was Friday. So Tracy, I'll be there in the morning. I'll be there tomorrow morning with the kids and all the food for T3, Tracy, and we're going to set everything up. We'll set everything up tomorrow morning. All right, and then we'll work with the puppy. I'm going to bring Clover and Romy.
We're to start with fearful border collie that is aggressive with strangers and unfamiliar dogs.
Ooh. All right. This is what I want you to do. Fully on-leash and off-leash obedience train that dog. So do baseline obedience with that dog. Build up its confidence by giving it some fun games to play. Tasser games. All right. You found a sofa? Awesome. Tracy, I really, really appreciate it. That's good. We'll probably be there about 10:30 tomorrow. And then what I want you to do is, I don't want anybody to interact with that dog right now. Anybody interact with that dog? Confidence goes up, fear goes down, you advocate for that dog, and then at one point you have to correct it. Extending the wireless to the AM2. Awesome. Awesome. Where? To the barn? Because it worked where my RV was. Chip, it worked where the RV was. Having trouble with walking my 6-month-old Doberman, she doesn't pull, but I feel tension on leash. So you gotta just teach that dog how to heal better. So what I want you to do is remote collar train that dog. Yeah, the Shake Shack I drove by today. So I want you to remote collar train the dog to heal. You can make a couple of quick 180s too. Make a couple of quick 180s. It's not an iPad. Oh, wow, awesome. That's nice of your friend. dog sprints all over the house when I let him in. What should I do? He kind of left. No, not 100. Nope. What I want you to do is I want you to teach that dog place. Teach that dog place. All right. I want you to teach that dog place. So place or down. Don't let your dog inside is not for running around. Inside is for relaxing, right? I don't let kids run around my house. I don't let dogs run around my house. That's what I got an outside for. That's what I have an outside for. Your dog doesn't like men. Well, what I would do is this. I've got a food advocacy counter conditioning video. You have to look at the video online. I don't have enough time to go through it right now because I've got to shut. Linda has to leave here at 10. She's got to put the kids to bed. Angelo's going to say his goodbyes. I'm off at 10:05. But I've got a video on a food advocacy counter conditioning protocol, and we do it with the dog's daily food, the daily food. And I assure you, within 2 weeks, your dog will not hate men. If it's a, chances are the dog just hasn't been socialized with enough men. It's usually what it is. It's usually what it is. There's just not enough socialization. There's not enough socialization. So if your dog is tense, waiting for it to break, then you're not doing it for long enough. Also, what I would want your dog to do is be on the remote collar. You can actually relax your dog with a remote collar. You can relax your dog with a remote collar. Your dog can actually go. We demoed that at the RB seminar the other day. Yep, remote collars are great. Remote collars are great. You believe someone broke his leg because it's 2 inches shorter? Ooh, that dog's probably gonna be in pain. So what I would do is I would look into some, they make a boot for that. They make a boot.
Good night, everybody.
All right. Bring Angelo out for his goodbyes. All right. So chances are I would get a special boot for that because that's gonna cause all kinds of problems, ligament problems, and if it's the back leg, hip problems, if it's the front, all kinds of problems with that dog. All kinds of dog. Three dogs, one foster, go by the springs to walk all together. Tips? Yeah, just add that third dog and away you go. Just get really, just, you know, just do the walk. Just do the walk like you own it. Like you own it. You're afraid to use the remote collar? Watch my videos, teach place. Teach place. What?
The girl's put in the bed.
Where is he?
He's in bed sleeping.
He's already in bed sleeping?
His own little bed sleeping.
Oh my gosh.
They put him to bed.
Anybody want to see Angelo sleeping?
No.
No, I can't. All right? So just do place for the first time. Your first command you're going to do is place. Just fall in love with the remote. Fall in love with it. Fall in love with it. E-Cower Technologies makes a great remote. Just fall in love with it. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. And that's my website. Sinstar, what's your dog doing growling at you? What'd you do? That's not good. Just tell it to shut up. Sinstar, just tell your dog. Guys, if your dog growls at you, tell them to shut up. They're dogs. You don't know? You don't know. Come on. Something happened. What's the difference between sit and place? Oh, a huge difference. Sit is sit, like sitting. Place is go to an object. Place is go to an object. So it's go to an object, like go to a dog bed, go to a blanket, go to a car mat, go to some defined area. And we usually do place, we do lie down usually. Sit is literally the dog sitting. But you can sit in place too. Boxer collie, they don't, I don't think the boxer collie or the border collie proof toys, I don't think there's any indestructible toys out there. So I don't know. I don't let my dogs chew on toys other than maybe you can use like a deer antler. Just get a deer antler. So you can have play toys with your border collie. You can do play toys with your border collie, but then you take them away. Do you know what I mean? It's like, oh, now we're done. And then give them a bone to chew. Have I always used tools? Yeah, I've always used tools. And I use food clickers, slip leads, remote collars, prong collars. I'll use spatial pressure, my voice. I use hand corrections, intent. Yep. Yeah, stuffed toys with squeak. I don't want, but to me, I don't freaking want to listen to a squeaker. What I'll be going coming to Indiana soon, I think. Indiana, up by close enough to Chicago, because it's going to be right up at the top. So Chicago's here, I'll be right there. But Sinstar, your dog's growling to the bone, I tell that dog to cut the crap right away, please. You don't do that. You don't do that. You're not allowed to do that in my house. You guys, you can correct your dog for stuff like this. It's okay. I once got a phone call from somebody that their dog was taking food. Oh, getting a dog to stop jumping is easy. Taking food off the table while they ate. Could you imagine that? I cannot imagine that. I cannot imagine sitting at a dinner table with my family, eating my food, and my dog comes up and takes the food. I cannot imagine that world. You've got to be effing kidding me. I'm not an advocate of hitting a dog, but freaking get the F away from me. Okay? Get the F away from me. We gotta be nuts. I can't imagine that life. Jeez. Now, next time, Sinistar, you better correct that dog. Growl at me, you gotta be nuts. There's not a video about Calm on Command. Calm on Command is everything I can do, everything I do. So when you start doing duration stuff, like duration stuff, such as place and down for long periods of time, having lots of rules and structure and guidance, having make sure there's no anxiety in the dog, then what the dog's gonna do is they'll be calm more. Like this. Oh, she just got up. Girl, no, pots. Nine, nine. Girl. So see how she lays down? So she lays down without purpose, other than relaxing. All right, it's 10:05, I have to go. Guys, I feel honored, I feel blessed that I can teach and that there's somebody here that can, that listens. I'll be back on Monday. We're here, Sinstar, I'm here for a month. Just private message me, Sinstar. I'm here for a month, all right? So come on now, right? Thank you so much. I'll see you over the weekend. Monday night, I'll definitely see you back with Linda. Jump on Linda's Periscope. It's WBiglashes. Yeah, Sinstar, let's get together if you're close. Canada, I'll be in Canada. RV Dog Training, rvdogtrainer.com. rvdogtrainer.com. I'll be in two dates in Canada. All right? All right. I love all of you, and I really mean it. All right, take care. Webinar Jam, I love you. Google Hangouts, goodbye.